Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, let's do this discount problem. A television is on sale for $770, which is 30% off the regular price of the television. What was the regular price? Okay, now remember, it's 30% off the regular price. Do not make the mistake of trying to take 30% off of the sale price, okay? To try to figure out the real regular price, that doesn't work. So we need to find out what the regular price is. So let's let R be the regular price. This is one way to do it. Okay, so how would you get the sale price? Well, there's this regular price, and then there's a discount, right? Which you take off. You have to get a subtract from the regular price, and that's 30% of the regular price. When it says 30% off of the regular price, it means it's going to take 30% off the regular price, not the 770. So how do you write 30% as a decimal? That'll be 0.3. So it's not just 0.3, it's 30% of the regular price, 0.3R. Hey, if you know how to finish this on your own, go for it. So R minus 0.3R, right, that's how much it would cost, right, once it's on sale, and we know that sale price is $770. So that's the equation. Next step is solving this equation. Right, what about R minus 0.3R? How do you deal with this? Well, these are like terms, remember, and when you have like terms, you subtract their coefficients. So this is 1R. Now, there are a couple ways you could solve this from here. You could subtract 1 minus 0.3 over here, 1.0 minus 0.3. To get your coefficient of r, and that'll be 0.7r equals 770. And then you could divide by 0.7 and use a calculator if you want. Or check this out. You don't really need a calculator for this. If you multiply the numerator and denominator by 10 here, you get to move each of these decimals over one so that it becomes 7700 over 7. So that'll give you $1,100. And then ask yourself if that seems like a reasonable amount. If the set is on sale for $770, that was 30% off. Does it make sense to you that the regular price was $1,100? Hopefully it does. But we could easily check what is 30% of $1,100. So you could check what's 30% of 1,100. That's 0.3 times 1,100, and that is $330. So if you take $330 off of this 1,100, right? You do get $770. So it does make sense that this regular price of the television set is $1,100. Now I'm going to do this problem by multiplying both sides by 10 first. This is another way to deal with your decimals. So just to show you a couple other ways you might solve this equation, and also another way you might think about the problem, just keep watching. All right, so what if I set it up this way, and instead of doing, and remember, really what you had was just the R. That's how we originally set it up. Now, when you have a decimal in a problem, one way of not dealing with decimals when you have an equation is multiply both sides by either 10 or 100 or 1,000 to move the decimal over. So if I multiply both sides of the equation by 10, what does this give me? I have to multiply 10 by each term on both sides of the equation. So I have 10 times r, which is 10r. And I have 10 times 0.3r. So what's 10 times 0.3? It's going to be 3. So that gives me 3R. And then I have to remember to also multiply the right-hand side of the equation by 10. 10 times 770 is 7700. Now, if you do this, then you don't have any decimals. So if the decimals trip you up, and combining like terms trips you up, get rid of the decimals, and usually it's easier to see what to do. So from here, I'm still getting, when I divide by 7, I'm going to get $1,100. Okay? So I end up getting the same answer. Now there's one other way to just consider this problem. If it's on sale for $770 and that's 30% off the regular price, then how much of the regular, what percent of the regular price are you paying? Okay, so you've got 30% off. How much is on? What percent are you still paying? Well, you're still paying 70%. So that's the last way you might consider writing your equation. So again, this is how we did it the first way, right? But somebody might just go directly to this. They may say, well, if it's 30% off, that means I'm paying 70% of the regular price. So they might just say, oh, 70% of the regular price is what I'm going to pay for it on sale, and that is $770. Now notice that is the same thing as 1R minus 0.3R. So some people, instead of writing R minus 0.3R and then combining like terms, go directly to 0.7R. And the way you're thinking of this is you're paying 70% of the regular price. Or how about thinking about this, the sale price. That is the sale price, right? 70% of the regular price is actually equal to the sale price. Okay, so there isn't just one way, to do any word problem, actually. A lot of people think of it differently. They might write a little bit different equation, a little bit different variables, but you do in the end want to make sure it makes sense, and our answer in this case is what matters. We did get $1,100 for the sale, I mean, for the regular price. So when all is said and done, that's what we want to write.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.